So some stats just in regard to Facebook. There's over 1.3 billion users. So you're probably not going to want to ignore those. You know, there's a fair amount of people using this thing out there. The average time spent per visit is 20 minutes, right? I did this yesterday. Who would go onto Facebook once a day? Twice? Three times? Who would spend more than an hour on Facebook a day? Who's here with their employer? Shows a cross-reference, that never. Who spends more than 2 hours a day on Facebook? For business or for personal use? Bit of both. I don't believe you. There's loads of people sitting there going, smirking away. I would probably spend about an hour a day on Facebook, kind of in and out, you know, maybe over 10 different times. But the brilliant thing is, see that average user time of 20 minutes? That's a really, really engaged user. That if you can get them to see your ads, your boosted posts, whatever it's going to be, you have a really good chance of interacting with them, you know, and doing something with it. Most people will spend on a website, maybe a minute, maybe 3 minutes. You know, and if you're trying to promote yourself through that to them, this can be a brilliant way to do it. More than a third of people in the UK visit Facebook every day. I would say that's very modest. I would actually say probably a third don't. And some of the top brands are the likes of Walls, New Look, Bentley. Do you know what I find really interesting about this? There's not a kick in the backside off these different amounts. I would imagine New Look's audience is slightly broader than Bentley's audience. So it just shows you people don't have to be interested in the product. I would doubt that Bentley think they have a model or a market of 2 million people in the UK that can buy prices of our cars at that price. But what it does show is you'll see people that maybe can't buy it, but they have an interest. They want to find out more. So it's not just accessing an audience. It can be accessing people for awareness and so on. Social advertising is highly effective. You get to engage with people who want to engage with you. You know, we all go on to Facebook because we're nosy. We want to find out information about our friends. What riles me is I go out. I'm from Bangor originally. Live in Belfast. I go to Bangor about once a year. You go into a pub and everybody will be like, "Oh, Mark, how are the kids?" I'm thinking, I haven't seen you in 15 years. My kids are 7 and 4. How do you know this? But we'll all have experienced it. We all go on. We want to find out about people we haven't seen in years. We don't really want to talk to them. We haven't spoken to them. They weren't our friends, but suddenly they are on Facebook. So we all want to engage because it's easy. You know, we don't have to talk to real people. You can also enhance brand loyalty. Get people to like you, follow your posts, interact with you, give you feedback, enter competitions, all that sort of stuff. And you can gain social recommendations from friends liking your posts. You know, we do it from a business point of view. If we put a post on and you see a level of engagement, you kind of think, yeah, did it. You put on a photo of your dinner. It drives me nuts. And then you pay, I like your dinner. That's the point. But it does give you that kind of, ooh, look how many likes I got. I'm really important. Whenever you're looking at the custom audiences, this is a great way to get really, really, really granular in who you want to put your ads in front of. So you're targeting ads to people you already have a relationship with by simply uploading an email address list, phone numbers, Facebook IDs, existing clients, existing people on your readership, your email lists, whatever it's going to be. So you could try to upsell them, get them to buy a similar product, do whatever it's going to be, give them a special offer for existing customers. But I think that's really powerful. Like how more targeted can you get than uploading an email list of people that have already bought something from you, interacted with you, whatever it's going to be, to try to sell them something else? In terms of targeting connections, you can do a number of different things. So you can get new likes by excluding current fans. There's no point really in wasting money promoting yourself to somebody that's already interacted, likes you or whatever, if the service isn't changed, if it isn't an upsell, like we just looked at. You can improve your post reach by targeting fans and their friends. At the end of the day, people are generally friends because they have shared interests. So why would you not try to look at that kind of lookalike audience side of it and target the friends of current fans? You can also look at people getting social recommendations by targeting people's fans. You know, so if you kind of look at that idea, such and such also likes. We all like to be included and be part of the big group. So it's a great way to get, you know, to promote a product to people that already, you know, a similar kind of demographic profile and get it in front of people. Do you guys, those of you that have used Facebook already, the insight tools, do you know the wee trick that if you change your language from English UK to English US? Do that. Brilliant. I'll show you in a wee second. So you can get loads and loads of insights about your audience before running your campaign, but you can also find loads of stuff after. So you can look at your desired audience by age, location, common interest. You can break it down by gender, relationship status, education, whatever it's going to be. You can look at the most popular categories and page likes. So people that like, you know, what other stuff do people like? What age group do they fall into that like our service? And you can also look at recent activity. What else have they done? And what devices have they been on? Have you guys seen that? there's more. See, if you change that slight bit of information, you change your language, you get a hell of a lot more out of it. The information that you will get for the, nothing else changes. It's not just US information, it's all about you. But for some reason, if you change the language, you get a powerful amount more. So you'll see in here, this is an insight tool into men in the UK and Ireland who are interested in shopping and fashion. So it's given us an idea here on pages that we could target. So pages such as the Lad Bible, Sports Bible, Dan Bilzerian, Unilad, Dapper Laughs, Paddy Power. You can see all the blokes in here kind of smiling. You started smiling at Dan Bilzerian, didn't you? been an interesting one for you to look up. So it starts to give you an idea about the relevance of these audiences. You know, if you're people that are interested in fashion in UK and Ireland frequently visit this. It gives you an affinity audience of 1.5 times, how many people are likely to see it, all that sort of stuff. It then gives you the relationship status of the people that you're likely to aim at. What have we got? Single, in a relationship, engaged, or married. We then have the device usage. So you're putting all this stuff together saying, right, where are my potential audience? We know they're on this site, we know this is their demographic, and we know they're using these devices. You can't get much better than that, really. So you'll see down here, there's things like, that one is people interacting with desktop only, desktop and mobile, mobile only, computers, phones, iPads, Android, BlackBerry, mobile web, feature phone, and unknown. How granular can you get to find out information about your client? The information is absolutely fantastic that comes out of it. The campaign that we're running at the minute is for a triathlon and athlete and cycling coaching company. And it's UK-wide to try to drive users to their website. So the strategy is we go on a certain age based on their demographic profiling. We know the location that we're targeting, and the interests are all to do with cycling, mountain biking, triathlons, velodrome, all that sort of stuff. And then you have our kind of social interactions here. Lots of likes, lots of shares, a few questions, but we're also monitoring that as conversions. Whenever people click through to the website, we know how many they're booking, actually booking these courses. Just some guidelines when it comes to using Facebook. You need to make sure you're targeting an appropriate audience. Hopefully you'll know what I mean. Don't put stuff in front of people that is inappropriate for them, because at the end of the day, they'll just complain and your ads will be taken down for being kind of dodgy. The creative should be relevant to the product. Don't just kind of use stock images or whatever you're going to do. I can imagine your stuff at Northern Ireland Tees being really, you know, I've seen the t-shirts and stuff, they're really bright, really visual. Lends itself absolutely perfectly to this sort of thing. Rolltac as well, obviously a very visual product. People will understand what it is by looking at it. Ads can't include images made up of more than 20% text. Includes logos or slogans. So you can't have your brand kind of emblazoned all over the whole thing. It has to be very much about the product or service. Images may not contain QR codes, those quick reaction code things, and images may not be stock images or scare tactics. Kind of was wondering about this one, you know, you can't put an ad up that says, click here or you may die. You know, I don't really get that scare tactic one, but it's important to kind of adhere to all of these things, because if not, Facebook will pull you down. We've all probably read in the papers about, you know, improper advertising on Facebook and people targeting people in different ways. Facebook are pretty tight on it now, you know, so if you do kind of contravene any of these things, they will pull you down pretty quickly.